हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू टू दिस वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ सेकंड ईयर जनरल पेपर. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर टू डिस्कस इंटोनेशन पैटर्न. वी नो दैट ईच एंड एवरी लैंग्वेज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड हैज सर्टन स्टाइल ऑफ अटरेंसेस और सर्टन स्टाइल ऑफ स्पीकिंग. सो इंटोनेशन कंसिस्ट ऑफ प्रोजोडी. सो दिस element of linguistics or the language which is called as prosody or suprasegment. It means the pitch, the loudness, the rhythm, the stress of the speaker varies the intonation pattern. So intonation refers to the pitch variation. There can be the rise and there can be fall in the pitch at the time of articulation or at the time of speaking. So we can define intonation as the pitch variation in definite structured ways with each distinct utterance to convey different modulations of the meaning that is conveyed by the words in the utterance. So intonation is defined as there is a pitch variation. There can be rise, there can be fall in the utterances or in the speech. So, two things are important here, the rise and fall in the statement or in the sentences. So, in order to convey different meaning, in order to give a new meaning, in order to create a new meaning, in order to make a different sense, the speaker varies his tone of utterances. He can change the meaning of utterances by using either falling tone or rising tone without adding or without altering any part of the word, without changing the position of the words or without adding new words into the sentence, into the utterances, just by changing the pitch, just by changing the stress, the speaker can modify, speaker can change, speaker can make a different sense. Speaker can create a new meaning. Speaker can use the stress pattern to request, to suggest, or it can be order, it can be threat. The intonation pattern changes the meaning of utterances or the statement. The intonation pattern vary with individual accents. So individual's utterance, individual styles of speaking, it varies from person to person, and this variation also affects the intonation, and this variation intonation also affects the meaning of utterance, meaning of articulation. So now number of times I have uttered here the pitch. So what is the meaning of pitch? It is also important to understand the meaning of pitch. So pitch refers to the vibration at vocal folds. During discussion on voiceless and voice sound, we talked about the vibration. The pitch of the person vibrates the vocal cords. When there will be less vibration, sometimes there can be less vibration, then can be more vibration at vocal cords. So degree of pitch determines vibration, degree of loudness, the stress, determines the vibration that will be created at the vocal folds or vocal cords. So intonation, we have to keep in mind, we have to remember, intonation refers to the tone of the speaker. The tone of the speaker changes the meaning of utterances just by changing the modulation, just by giving the stress to proper sentence, to proper word, the meaning is also altered or meaning is also changed. So in English, next concept that we have to discuss is the tone groups. So in English, sentences, longer sentences are needed to be reduced into smaller component or smaller groups. When sentences are organized or sentences are arranged into smaller components or smaller units of words, we call it as a tone group. So we know that all sentences consist of words, phrases and clauses. So longer sentences are needed to be divided into smaller component or smaller groups. With such division of sentences is referred as tone groups. So there are certain considerations where tone groups takes place. How we divide the sentence into a smaller group, it depends upon three considerations. There are three things. First one is we have to consider grammar. Second thing is we have to consider punctuation, and the third thing is the focus should be on semantic consideration. So according to the tone group, we have to keep in mind the speaker has to divide the sentence into smaller component or smaller unit to make the specific meaning. This division of the tone group changes the meaning of the speaker. Now we are going to see through examples how the speaker can changes the meaning by just changing the tone group. Now let us see here example. Now the student said the teacher is very lethargic. The sentence is the student said teacher is very lethargic. So this sentence can be divided into a tone group. In order to divide a tone group, we have to give such sort of mark here. Put two vertical lines. The student said, this is one sentence. The student said, teacher is very lethargic. So this longer sentence is divided into two component, two group. First group is the student said. The second one is teacher is very lethargic. So the same sentence, when its tone group is changed, it will have a different meaning. Now look at the sentence like this. The student said, the student, the first tone group, the student said teacher is very lethargic. Now this sentence is divided into three groups. We haven't added any word, we haven't deleted any word, we have just changed the sentences. We have changed the sentence into a different group. The student said teacher is very lethargic. So meaning is changed here. In the first utterance, in the first example, the teacher was lethargic. But in the second example, just by changing the position of group, we have changed the meaning. Now here the student is lethargic and the speaker is teacher. So tone group modulates, tone group changes the meaning of utterance. So tone group is very important to understand the meaning of the speaker. As I told earlier, there are three considerations as far as the tone group is concerned. We have to keep in mind the sentences, longer sentences are divided into smaller groups. So first consideration of tone group is grammatical consideration. As I told earlier, sentence consists of words, phrases and clauses. In a sentence, we have to divide the sentence into a group considering a phrase, a clause of that sentence. Now let us see the example. One of my friends from Nashik. One of my friends from Nashik has won a lottery. So this is a longer sentence. This sentence can be divided into a smaller group considering the grammar. We have to consider the clause element of this sentence. Now First group will be one of my friend from Nashik. So this will be one group, and the second one will be has won a lottery. So grammatical consideration, we have to focus on phrases or a clause that is used in a sentence or that is used in utterances. So we can divide the sentence rather than uttering it as one of my friends from Nashik has won a lottery. We have to divide it to smaller group to make it more meaningful. So it will be one of my friend from Nashik has won a lottery. Then same is with the example. When they saw the thieves, the dogs started barking. So we have here two clauses. The first one is when they saw the thieves, the dogs started barking. So two clauses are here, and according to consideration of grammatical, we have to divide it into a small group. That is, the first group will be when they saw the thieves, and the second group will be the dogs started barking. Then the second consideration is of punctuation. To divide the sentence into a tone group, we have to focus our attention on clues from punctuation. It helps us to divide sentence into a group. So punctuations like full stop, colon, semicolon, comma will help us to end of the tone group. So grammatical consideration is there, then punctuation is there. So punctuation we have to keep in mind, comma we have to keep in mind, semicolon, full stop. It will help the speaker or the communicator or the user to identify the tone group. Here he should stop, here he should, how he should divide the sentence into tone group. It could be understood through punctuation mark. Now look at the example. I think I know all about Taj Mahal, although I have never actually seen it. The sentence is, I think I know all about Taj Mahal, although I have never seen it. So as per punctuation, as per criterion of punctuation, we have to consider the colon, semicolon or full stop. So this sentence can be put into a tone group like this. I think I know all about Taj Mahal. So this will be the first group, because here is a comma. Comma is used here. So I think I know all about Taj Mahal. The second group will be, although I have never actually seen it. So longer sentences can be divided into a small group to make it more meaningful, to make it more emphatic. We can also divide sentence like this. On Saturday, they will leave for Delhi. On Saturday, they will leave for Delhi. So we have to keep in mind, we have to focus on punctuation marks that are used in the sentences. For example, on Saturday, here is a comma, they will leave for Delhi. So this sentence can be divided into tone group like this. First will be on Saturday, this is a tone group. The next tone group will be they will leave for Delhi. After punctuation, the third one is semantic consideration. So semantic refers to meaning. Sometimes we have to divide a sentence according to the distribution of meaning. So semantic clues are important to understand to divide the sentence into a smaller groups, that is smaller tone groups. Now look at the example. There is a well-known city in Kashmir called Srinagar. I had an opportunity to go there as a part of a delegation. So this is a longer sentence. So we have to consider the meaning to divide this sentence according to tone group. We are going to write down that sentence. There is a well-known city. Called there is a well-known city in Kashmir called Srinagar, comma. Then there will be, I had an opportunity to go there as a part of delegation. So it is a longer sentence. In order to divide into small group, we have to consider the meaning. So we can start from, there is a well-known city in Kashmir. So this will be the first tone group. The second will be called Srinagar. Then I had an opportunity to go there as a part of delegation. So we can divide the sentence into small group like this. This will be the first group. There is a well-known city in Kashmir called Srinagar. This is the second tone group. I had an opportunity to go there. This will be the third one. And fourth one will be as a part of delegation. So remember, the tone group is essential. Tone group is important to divide the sentences into a smaller group so that the speaker's meaning can be understood by the listener. So there are certain considerations, there are certain things, criteria we have to keep in mind. The first one is grammatical consideration, second one is punctuations, and third one is semantic consideration. So this lecture will help you to understand how sentences can be divided into smaller tone groups.